The 10th chapter is letters. This is the format of writing a letter. On the top left, we start the letter with the sender's address. In a line below to the right, we mention the date. Then again to the left below the date, we write the name of the receiver, followed by his designation and his address. This is followed by salutation like dear sir or dear madam, etc. Then comes the subject line, which is nothing but the purpose of the letter in a single line. Then we start with the actual content, which is divided into three parts. The first is introduction, in which we try to tell who we are and what we exactly want. This is followed by the body of the letter, which describes the details about what you want. And finally, the conclusion, where we mention our expectations from the receiver. And once the content gets over, we write the closing subscriptions by mentioning, thanking you, yours sincerely. Then the writer of the letter puts his signature, and followed by the designation of the sender. So this is the format of writing an official letter. Next is the circular. When the organization wants to inform all the members of a particular department or the members of the entire organization about something simultaneously, then it sends them a circular. Circular is generally related to some instruction which must be followed in future. This is a specimen of an official circular. On the left side we write the circular number, on the right side we write the date, then we give the heading office working hours, because the circular is about the working hours in the office. Then we mention for whom the circular is written, and this time it is for all the employees. Then the actual content of the circular begins. And this is an official confirmation about the office timings that have to be followed strictly by all the employees. Being an outsourcing organization, we maintain a different pattern of work hours as compared to the normal. It is a